everyone, my name is Laurie Talon. I work in the hematology laboratory of the University Hospital of Clermont-Ferrand. We have evaluated the analytical performances of a new immunoturbidimetric D-dimer assay. Widespread daily use of D-dimer assay for exclusion of venous thrombembolism led to development of many assays. However, their usefulness depends on their reliability and performance. The objective of this study was to evaluate the analytical performances of the Yumizen G DDi 2 assay, HORIBA Medical, performed with the Yumizen G 800 analyzer and to compare it with other available D-dimer assays. From BioMérieux, Diagnostica Stago, Siemens Healthineers, and Werfen. Within run and between run imprecision were evaluated using the low and high quality control plasmas. Limit of detection, limit of quantification, and linearity were determined according to the Clinical and Laboratory Standards Institute. Interferences due to hemolysis, icterus, or lipemia were evaluated by spiking plasmas with hemolysate, bilirubin, or enteralipin. Comparison studies were carried out using fresh citrate plasma samples collected from 66 consecutive routine patients with a wide range of D-dimer concentrations. Comparison with other available assays was evaluated with the Bland-Altman plot analysis. The coefficient of variation values of within and between day imprecision were in accordance with the specifications by Ricos and colleagues. The assay imprecision for plasma samples close to the threshold of 500 nanogram per milliliter fibrinogen equivalent unit was satisfactory and comparable to what reported earlier for the Vidas D-Dimer Exclusion II assay. The assay linearity was very good for a broad range of concentrations, up to 32,700 nanograms per milliliter fibrinogen equivalent unit with manual redilution. The figure 1 represents the bias in D-dimer measurement in function of hemoglobin, bilirubin, and lipid levels. Dotted lines represent the limit of acceptable bias. Each color corresponds to a plasma sample, and the different points correspond to the different concentrations of hemoglobin, bilirubin, and intralipid spiked in the samples. Hemolysis did not have any impact on D-dimer measurement up to hemoglobin concentrations of 10 g per liter. The 10 samples tested had an acceptable bias, particularly in samples with D-dimer values around the threshold value. The bias did not exceed 5%, whatever the hemoglobin concentration. Icterus did not exert any analytical interference up to the highest bilirubin concentration tested of 300 mg per liter. Conversely, lipemia seemed to underestimate D-dimer concentration when intralipid concentration was greater than 5 g per liter. This figure shows Bland-Altman plots on the D-dimer values obtained with the Yumizen G DDi 2 assay and the Yumizen G 800 analyzer and other available assays. The x-axis represents the mean of the measurements and the y-axis represents the difference between the measurements obtained with the two systems. Continuous and dotted lines represent the bias and the lower and upper limits of agreement. Bland-Altman analysis revealed highly agreement between Yumizen G DDi 2 assay and all other assays. Some random discrepancies were observed above the cutoff value, without any clinical impact concerning the exclusion of the venous thrombembolism diagnosis. In conclusion, the analytical performances and the main technical features of the new Yumizen G DDi 2 assay make it a suitable method for the rapid quantification of D-dimer in clinical laboratories.